Clint Eastwood is one of those rare Hollywood stars who has both appeared in and directed a heaps of box office hits. And at the age of 88, the Oscar winner has just clocked up another hit flick in The Mule. Clint stars as Earl, a broke 90-year-old horticulturalist who takes a job as a drug courier for a Mexican cartel to earn a living. Angela Bishop has the story. Wow.
Once in a while, somebody puts a story out that you get interested in, and this is very different from anything I've ever done before.
Tell me, is he mad? Is he bad? Is he naive? What is Earl's
All of those. All of the above. Yeah. He's finding his way along in life. And, you know, he's obviously somewhat eccentric. Not many people in his age group would be out doing daylilies, a plant that only lasts, only blooms one night and then it's gone. But he finally finds an illegal way to finance himself. And so he lets his guard down and decides he goes over to the criminal side.
Don't look in that bag. You might think you can identify us, but don't forget, we know who you are.
Mexican drug cartels are a real threat. It's part of the political conversation. How do you think this movie speaks to what's going on in America at the moment?
Their presence here in the United States is solidified and it's here. But I think that the main message of this movie is more about family, spending time with family, and that, you know, your job isn't your number one priority, or at least it shouldn't be. The show that I just did, Narcos, that one talks a little bit more in depth about, you know, the relations between America and Mexico and the drug war. You're looking at the people that are selling it, right? And we have a neighboring country that's very poor. While you do and can blame the narcos, we have to look at it maybe as a health issue with addiction, because if without the demand, there is no supply. There was something in the air that night,
so the last two roles I've interviewed you for back-to-back were singing and dancing with Cher in Mamma Mia 2 and now playing the head of a drug cartel with Clint Eastwood.
Well, they were all on the bucket list, you know, Cher and Diane and Clint, you know, so those are three checks right there, you know.
Did Clint live up to your expectations?
Oh,
what was he like?
Of course. You didn't even know that it was even happening.
Really?
It just happened, you know.
Painless.
It was like,
I thought it was more important to be somebody out there than the damn failure I was in my own home. Don't let the old man
in. So what was it like to watch your father take on that mantle of this rather eccentric character?
I was really surprised that he was doing this film. He's somebody who absolutely hates drugs, and he's not from the 60s. He's older than that, so he didn't go through that whole hippie dope smoking taking acid thing, you know. Both of my parents are so straight-laced. And so I was really surprised that he was going to play somebody that was going to be driving around with a bunch of blow in the back of his truck. But, you know, I mean, it's obviously not just about that. It's really about his character and the choices that he makes and how he gets himself into this conundrum.
You are in the biz as a director as well. Does he give you advice?
Right, I give
back to,
him
do you give
advice.
It right back to him? Yeah, excellent.
Yeah, you should.
Exactly. He's not much for giving advice. The first time I directed, he said, just get a lot of sleep. You're going to need it. And that was all he said, but it was very subtle in his way. But, you know, his advice to me and I to all of my siblings has been, you know, do what you love to do. Do the best job you can do. Show up. Be kind to people. Be prepared. We were raised to be, you know, very humble and very appreciative of our circumstances and our life, and the fact that, you know, we got to grow up running around on a movie set. And, you know, I think that he's just sort of shown more by example than giving advice.
Sure.
As a director, you know, before I went off to shoot my first film, I went out and spent a couple of weeks with him, sort of shadowing him on a film, and it was amazing because I had never really sat there and just paid attention to him as a director. I've always sort of been flitting about and having fun, so I think just watching him by example has really been more profound for me than any verbal advice he could give. Don't let the old man in. Look out your window and
smile. Don't let the old man.
He's extraordinary. Imagine being 88 years old.
He's amazing.
Doing that.
Amazing.
He's amazing.
Yeah. I don't plan on still working at 38.
But he's been taking Joe Hockey's advice.
Yeah. Now, what a great guy. Yeah. Having his daughter speak about him like that, the relationship that they had with all the siblings, what the knowledge and what he passed on to his kids. What being humble, being kind to people, do what you love. I just think that's extraordinary. Yeah. Nice to come out of Hollywood.